What exactly is a shelf offering? Get it? It's a shelf. And how do we, as day traders, use this to our advantage? When we're trading penny stocks that gapped up huge pre-market. Today, as a follow-up to my last how to read SEC filings video, we will be taking a closer look at NERV in its filings. So by the end of this video, you'll be able to do a quick 10-minute research and deciding on whether a penny stock runner is a long, or in this case, a conviction all day short. If that sounds like something that interests you, make sure to smash your like button and subscribe. Now let's jump right into SEC filings Form S-3. Form S-3 is an official document that all public companies have to file in order to register new shares to do an offering. It's usually the first SEC filing I look at when deciding whether a penny stock company will likely have any overhead supply of debt securities or ATM offerings. The second form after that is usually the 10K or the 10Q, which are the financial statements. And how you find these filings is through SEC Edgar. Once you're there, just type in the ticker you're looking for, which is NERV, N-E-R-V. This stock is the hot stock of the day that gapped up pre-market on June 24th. The company announced some achievements in primary or secondary endpoint. You know, the usual fluffy stuff. This isn't FDA news. They are just using this PR as a way to pump their share prices up from 430s the night before to 750s or 760s pre-market. And if you've seen many of my previous day trading videos on these penny stock pumps, you know that companies like these, they usually have an alternative motive. And we're about to find out why. So once you search out NERV in the SEC Edgar, look for Form S-3. And in this case, the latest one was the one filed in August of 2018. And bam, right there, this is in the registration to raise $200 million for this company. That's quite a substantial amount. And whenever you see a penny stock company has an S-3 for that kind of number, that's a red flag right there. I always take a look at the prospectus as well, and right there you can see that this S-3 is for a shelf offering. Shelf registration means that the shares registered in this filing totaling up to $200 million can be sold by this company in any given time within the next 3 years. After finding out about this $200 million shelf, it's also very important to research to see if this shelf can indeed be used by this company at this time. I'll show you how to find out whether the shelf is effective in just a little bit. It sounds complicated, but it's very simple, I promise. So inside this prospectus, if you read a little bit further, it'll give you a description of the company. And here we find out that NERV is a biotech company. And biotech pharmaceuticals and healthcare companies, they are cash burning machines. Because first of all, these biotech companies, they are often not making revenue at all while they are developing their drugs. Their drugs have to be developed and approved by the FDA in order to be sold in the market. And all the trials and the tests that these drugs have to be pushed through, those cost a lot of money. And second of all, these biotech companies, they often have the highest paid C-suites and board members as well, and generally more than other sectors. So that's why penny stock biotech companies are usually poor for cash. They have expensive trials and tests to pay for those drugs. And on top of that, they have to pay fat dough for the executives and bonuses. So whenever you see these biotech penny stocks release PR to pump their shares prices up, they are likely setting it up to do an offering. Not always though. Again, nothing in day trading is 100% guaranteed. But knowing this and confirming your thesis in the SEC filings will give you that edge. I bet the guru DVDs you paid thousands of dollars for didn't teach you this. So make sure to drop me a like button if you haven't already. I really appreciate it. But there's more in this S-3. So besides telling the total amount of money they're trying to raise and the type of company this stock is, this filing will also tell you the kind of securities that this shelf registration is allowed to sell. And this is where you can find this, under the prospectus. NERV, this company is allowed to sell common stock, preferred stock, debt, and warrants. And to be more technical and specific about the shelf registration, this is what we call a mixed shelf. Meaning that this shelf registration does not limit this company to just sell common stock, to just sell warrants. They can literally sell anything that's listed under the prospectus. And they do list out all the securities and the amount they're worth in detail in this S3 or the 10K, which I have in another video talking through those in detail. So why use a mixed shelf? If the penny stock company do plan on dumping on their investors and unsuspecting buyers while they conveniently pump their share prices up, it makes sense that they wouldn't want to limit themselves to just common stock or just warrants. They want to be able to sell anything they have, as long as they can raise that $200 million registered in this shelf. And that's why it's called a shelf. The company filed for the S3, got the shares registered by the SEC, and once it's approved for the amount of $200 million, they can literally put these approved shares up on a shelf. These are worth $200 million worth of shares. And they can decide anytime down the road when they are gonna sell these shares. And once they decide to use this shelf, they can literally just like dump on their investors. Okay, this is getting out of hand. Instead of going out to party on a long weekend, I'm in my room filming myself holding a shelf. So that brings us to the next point I mentioned earlier. How do we know that this shelf registration can actually be used? Because these form the S3 once filed, go under review by the SEC. That can take anywhere from 10 days to a couple of months, depending on whether the company meets the guidelines. And once approved, this S3 becomes in effect. So here's how you check whether this S3 specifically for NERV is in effect. You go to SEC Edgar again. Once you found the most current S3 for this company on SEC Edgar, go to the file number and click on it. Here it is, effect. If an S3 for any of the tickers you're looking for doesn't have effect on it, that means the company cannot use it. Not yet, anyways. This is very simple to check, but very important to know whether this shelf can actually be used. So now that we know NERV has an S3 for $200 million and that's in effect, there's one more thing we can find out in this filing. And I mentioned about this in my previous video, ATM offerings. NERV also has a deal with Jefferies to be able to sell $50 million worth of common stock shares at the market, meaning that they can execute the sale anytime during market hours. Jefferies LLC is one of those usual suspects that these penny stock companies love to deal with when they are planning for their offerings. So these underwriters do the deal for them, and they get paid with fees and sometimes preferred stock, which they can also sell at the market during these offerings. So it's a win-win situation for the penny stock company and the underwriter, but a lose big situation for the investors buying. So whenever you see the name Jefferies in the penny stock's SEC filings, that should raise some red flags. And besides Jefferies, there are a few more underwriters that you should be aware of. And if you stay till the end, you'll find out. And all that research, looking into the company's SEC filings for an S3, seeing if there's a shelf registration or ATM offerings, or whether or not the S3 is in effect, can be quickly done in under 10 minutes by using keyword search. Control F, my friends, is the best shortcut that you'll ever need. And I go through further detail about penny stock balance sheets, whether or not there's dilution and offerings in the past, in the other SEC filings video. So go check that out if you haven't already. And this video right now specifically is for me to research on whether or not a penny stock gap up pre-market will hold. Basically, whether I should lean into the stock NERV long or a short all the way down, filling an entire gap. Yes, you can argue that you don't really need to do this kind of SEC filing research if you are just trading intraday. But finding out about this $200 million worth of shelf and $50 million worth of ATM is what gave me the conviction to start shorting NERV and adding into this winner short when the stock breaks the pre-market low as per my gap up strategy. And really, that's all I personally use the SEC filings for. Specifically, the S1, S3, and the 10K and 10Q. I use it for short-term trading and looking at whether a stock that's had a run up has any overhead supply. And if it does, like with NERV and YRIV, I want to be short biased. And I would never loan these stocks overnight because you're running the risk of being dumped on after hours or the next day. Now, if the penny stock company has a lot of cash, no need to do an offering and actual good fundamental news, then I would consider swinging the stock long. That's exactly what I said about Zyne, Z-Y-N-E. In that video, I checked the balance sheets and the filings for Zyne, and I said if the stock can hold $8, then I would consider to swing it long. And since then, Zyne has ran up to a high of $16 and is currently at $13 now. But of course, I was that idiot who sold at $11. So this kind of fundamental SEC filings research really helps when I'm day trading and swing trading, both for long and short. But remember, you can be fundamentally right, but technically wrong. That's why it's so important to enter these conviction trades according to your own technical setups. And still, don't forget your risk management. And how exactly do you manage your risk, especially with a small account? Well, you're in luck. I want you to subscribe and ring that notification bell, because in next week's video, I will be going over day trading risk management, especially if you have a small account. And I'll be doing a special giveaway to a few of my subscribers who watch and comment on the risk management video within the first 1 or 2 hours. And no, I haven't forgotten about the underwriters. And I really want to give back to my loyal subscribers who are always smashing those like buttons, watching my videos, and leaving me really thoughtful comments. I do read them all and I really appreciate it. And that's why I always make sure to spend 8 to 12 hours on these YouTube videos to make sure everything is 99.9% value and zero hype. And maybe like 0.1% of bad jokes. So make sure to have that notification bell enabled to see that risk management video and enter the giveaway. So besides Jefferies, the other two underwriters that these penny stock companies love to deal with when doing offerings, they are Maxim and H.C. Wainwright. So whenever you find those names in the SEC filings, something's up. Thank you guys for watching as always. I'm the Humbled Trader and I'll see you guys next week. Salaries and bonuses. To holy shit, I broke my shelf.